So in the last lecture, we have taken the problem on structural analysis, and that is basically on the spring. Okay. So as I told you in the last lecture, today we'll be doing the thermal analysis. Today we'll be dealing with thermal analysis. Today we will take the problem on thermal analysis, right? So now let's see the problem. Let's see the problem. Okay. So a composite wall consists of three materials as shown in figure. The outer temperature TO is equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Convection heat transfer takes place on the inner surface of the wall with T infinity is equal to 800 degree Celsius. And H is equal to 30 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Determine temperature distribution. Determine temperature distribution. Determine the temperature distribution in the wall. Determine the temperature distribution in the wall. Okay, so try to understand. So this is basically the problem statement which is given. Okay, so K1 is given as 25 watt per meter degree Celsius. You know what is K1? Okay, it's a thermal conductivity. This year you will be studying now in the thermal engineering, right? So then K2 is equal to 30 watt per meter degree Celsius. K3 is equal to 70 watt per meter degree Celsius. So now I will draw the diagram. Okay, so okay, let's consider this phase. So this is one phase. Okay, this is one part of the wall. Okay, which they are given with conductivity K1, with conductivity K1, and of length 0.3 meter. Okay, one more they have. Okay, with conductivity K2. Okay, so of length 0.2 meter. Okay, then one more they have. Okay, with conductivity K3, and with the length, okay, this is 0.15 meter. See, this is I am calling as a length. It's not actually the length. It is nothing but the thickness of the wall. Okay, so see here, all of you. So on this side, what you have on this side, you have heat flow. Okay, on this side you have heat flow with value as H, with value of H and T infinity. So here heat transfer coefficient is H and temperature is T infinity. While here your temperature is TO. on this side the temperature is. Okay, so this is basically the problem which is given. Okay, try to understand the problem. I will repeat the problem because it is very important that first you understand the problem. A composite wall consists of, okay, so a composite wall consists of three materials. Okay, so this is basically the composite wall which is made up of three materials. So this is one material with conductivity K1. You have one more material with conductivity K2, and you have one more material with conductivity K3. Okay, so this is a composite wall. This is a wall which is made up of these three materials having conductivity K1, K2, and K3. And each material, it is having thickness of this material, it is having thickness 0.3. This material, it is having thickness 0.2. This material, it is having thickness 0.15. Okay, the outer temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, so see, if you just consider the left-hand side as the inner surface, obviously your right-hand side is the outer surface. So on the outer surface, your temperature is TO, and value of TO is given as 20 degrees Celsius. If you want, I will write down TO as 20 degrees Celsius. So on outer side, temperature is TO, and that is 20 degrees Celsius. Convection heat transfer takes place on the inner surface of the wall. So see, if this is the outer, obviously this will be the inner surface. So on inner surface, what happens is convection takes place. And for convection, what do you require? You require heat transfer coefficient as well as, for convection, you require heat transfer coefficient, right? So this is what H is given. So convection heat transfer takes place on the inner surface of the wall with T infinity is equal to 800. So on the inner surface, value of temperature, that is T infinity, is equal to 800 degrees Celsius, and H is equal to 30 watt per meter square degree Celsius. So this H, it is 30 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Now they're asking, determine the temperature distribution in the wall. Now see, all of you, here temperature is T infinity, okay? Temperature is T infinity. Then we need to calculate what is the temperature here, 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 and here, right? We are supposed to do that. So this is the thing in which we are interested. This is the thing in which we are interested. So basically, our interest is to calculate the value of temperature. Our interest is to calculate the value of temperature. Now see, as you know, see, this is air. This is air. So from air to this face of the wall, try to understand. This is air which is flowing. Okay. So from this air to this face of the wall, heat will be conducted by convection, okay? Because this is basically the fluid and this is basically the solid. So from fluid to solid, heat will be conducted by conduction, okay? So let me draw that, okay? See here, in order to start with the solution of the problem, okay, now we will start with the solution. So from here to here, okay, try to understand. From this air to this face of the wall, heat will flow by convection. Now from this phase to this phase, it will go by conduction. Again from this to this, it will go by conduction. Again from this, okay, this phase to this phase, the heat will flow by conduction. Okay, now let's start with the solution. Okay, so as I told you, see, from this, see, you can see here, from air to this phase of the wall, the heat flow will take place due to convection. Okay, so I will just draw that element. Okay, try to understand. Okay, so this is basically the convection element. See, this is air and this is the face of the wall. Okay, try to understand. See, if you want, I will just bring it down. Okay, see, this is the air, and from air to the face of the wall, this is basically the face of the wall, the heat will flow by convection. Now from this face of the wall to this face of the wall, obviously your heat will flow by conduction. Okay. So from here to here, try to understand. From here to here, the heat will flow by conduction, right? Now we will go to the next point. Now we have the heat here. So from here to here, again the heat will flow by conduction, right? Again from here to here, it will flow by conduction. Try to understand. Are you getting this one or not? Let me know. Are you getting this one or not? Let me know about that. Is that okay? See, in thermal engineering, okay, you're seeing the three modes of heat transfer. Okay, first is conduction. Conduction generally occurs from solid to solid. See, this is a solid, this is again solid. So from this to this, heat will flow from by conduction. Again, from K2 to K3, the heat will flow by conduction because these are the solids which are attached to each other. Now, when you talk about the heat flow from the air, which is basically the fluid, okay, air, which is basically the fluid, to the solid, okay, so fluid to the solid, obviously this will be the convection. Okay, so I will write down this element number one. Element number one I have written for conduction, okay. Then I will write down this element number two. Okay, this is for conduction. See, this is for convection. Element number one for convection. Element number two, it is for conduction. Element number three, okay, it is again for conduction. Okay, and finally element number four, okay, it is for conduction. Try to understand. This is air from. This is the air which is flowing, okay, through the wall. So when the air is going to come into the contact with the inner surface of the wall, okay, this is the inner surface of the wall. So from the air to inner surface of the wall, the heat will flow by convection. Now, from this surface to this surface, heat will flow by conduction. Again, from this surface to this surface, heat will flow by conduction. Again, from this surface to this surface, heat will flow by conduction. Is that okay with this one? Let me know. Is that okay? All of you? Is that okay or not? Let me know about that. Okay, now see. Now we will write down element matrix equation. Try to understand. We will write down we have just write down the elements. Okay, we have not yet numbered the node. Okay, so I'll number the node. This is node number one, node number two, node number three. Okay, this is node number four. Okay, and this is node number five. Okay, this is node number five. So node number one, two, three, four, and five. Now, so I will write down now element matrix equation. That is basically we used to write down as EME. So element matrix equation EME for convection. Okay, we are talking about convection. For convection. Okay, so for element matrix equation for convection. Okay, in the very first lecture, I have written all those EMEs. Okay, so which is given by H into A, 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. Okay, into temperature. These are T1 and T2. Is given by heat flow, that is Q1 and Q2. Okay, so this is basically the equation, element matrix equation. So it is HA 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 T1 T2 is equal to Q1. Now see, if you just see this term, it is called as element stiffness matrix. This has to be multiplied by, okay, temperature will be given by heat flow, right? So if you want the heat to flow, obviously you should have a temperature difference, right? So if you want the heat to flow, obviously there has to be some temperature difference, right? Okay. So I see this from where this formula has been came. It is basically derived from Newton's law of cooling, right? H into A. This has been basically derived from Newton's law of cooling, right? Now let us write down this equation for element number one, because in element number one we have convection. Okay. So if I need to write down the value of element stiffness matrix for element number one, I will write down this as H. What is the value of H? It is given H. It is 30. H is 30 into A, right? Now, what is the area? Area in convection, it's a surface area. Area which is in convection, it is basically the surface area, right? You see, if I just draw the 3D diagram, okay, for this particular wall, okay, so it might going to appear like this. Okay, so let me draw that. Okay, I will just draw that 3D diagram. Okay, so this is basically the diagram which is having conductivity K1. Here you have conductivity K2. And here we have conductivity K3. Okay, K1, K2, K3. Okay, So see, for convection, you required surface area. Our heat is flowing like this. Try to understand. This is the heat which is flowing like this, and heat will come out of this, right? It will enter through this. It will enter through this phase, and it will come out of this phase, right? So if you just see this particular area, okay? If you just see this particular area, so this is the area. This is the surface area, right? This is the surface area. So this is nothing but your surface area, right? So see, what we'll do, we will assume this area to be 1 meter square, right? So when you assume this area as 1 meter square, you will get the value of heat flow in watt per meter square. Try to understand. So when we'll assume that area as 1 meter square, this is a surface area. This is a surface area for convection. This is a surface area for convection. Okay. So we will assume that area as 1 meter square. Okay. And whatever the amount of heat we will get will be in watt per meter square, because that will be for only 1 meter square of area. Okay. So I will assume this as a 1. Try to understand. So I will write down here cross section area. If you want, I will just mark here area. Area is equal to 1 meter square. Area is equal to 1 meter square. That I will assume. Okay. See, the same thing is going to do in thermal engineering. Okay. So when you take the area in as 1 meter square, when you take the area in 1 meter square, you will get the value of heat in watt per meter square, and that is basically known as heat flux. Okay. When you have the value of Q in watt per meter square, okay, so that is nothing but called as heat flux. Okay. So that you're going to see in the thermal engineering, right? I will not go into the detail for that. So I will take the area as 1, okay, into 1 minus 1 minus 1 1, okay, into 1 minus 1 minus 1 1, right? So if you just see this one, 30 into 1, it's a 30, okay? So 30, then minus 30 and plus 30, okay? 30 minus 30 minus 30 and plus 30, right? Now see, if you see this element number 1, it is between node 1 and 2. So I'll write on that as 1, 2, 1. This is 1, 2 and 1. 1, 2, 1. So this is all about what? Repeat it for conduction element, right? So we will do that. So we will go now for conduction element. Now we will go for conduction element. So let's start with element number 2. Let us start with element number 2. Okay, so this is basically the right conduction element, right? So for that we should know the EME, right? We should know the EME. So I will write down element matrix equation. Element matrix equation, that is basically EME. Element matrix equation, that is basically EME for conduction. For conduction. Okay, now we are talking about conduction. So for conduction, you require thermal conductivity. Okay, so we have the formula Ka by L into 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. That is EME into T1 T2 is equal to Q1 Q2 is equal to Q1. So this is basically the formula for element matrix equation for conduction. Ka by L, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1, T1, T2 is equal to Q1, right? So now let's apply this equation for element number 2. Okay, now let us apply this equation for element number 2. So I will write down K2, right? Element stiffness matrix for element number 2. How I'll do that? Conductivity of element number 2. See, this is the element number 2. Whose conductivity is K1. And now let's check with the value of K1. It's 25, right? It's 25 into area. So area, see, here area, try to understand. Here area was the surface area. Here area was the surface area, right? But here area is cross-section area, okay? Because it's a conduction. Okay, cross section area. So heat is flowing like this. Try to understand. So heat is flowing like this. Okay. So cross section area, it is here. It is same as surface area. Try to understand. So if you just go here, and if you just take the cross section here, try to understand. If you just mark this area, okay. If you just mark this area, so you will get same area which is as a surface area. Okay, try to understand. So this area, yellow area, which I have initially highlighted, which was the surface area, it is same now as a cross section area. So here area is again, I will take it as 1 meter square. Area, I will take it as 1 meter square. Okay. Area, I will take it as 1 meter square. And which is basically the cross sectional area. Which is basically the cross sectional area. Right? The area will be a cross sectional. Which is a cross section area, right? So I will put those values. I'll just put those values. Cross section area, now I will put it as 1. Okay. Upon length of element number 2, length of element number 2, it's 0.3. Right? It's 0.3. Into 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. Okay. So just do this calculation and let me know immediately how much we're getting. 25 into 1 divided by 0.3. Let me know this. How much we're getting?
83.33.
How much?
83.33.
Okay. 83.33. Minus 83.33. Right? So this is a equation which we get. Now see, if you talk about element number 2, it is between 2, 3. So write down, this is 2, 3 and 2, 3. Now let's move to element number 3. Okay, now let's move to the element number 3. So I will write down now element stiffness matrix for element number 3. For element number 3 is given by, okay, its conductivity. Conductivity of element number 3, it is K2, and value of K2, let's check, it's 30. It's 30, right? K2, it's 30. Into area, we have taken as 1 meter square. Upon length, that is nothing but it's the thickness of element number 3. It is 0.2. It is 0.2. Right? It's a 0.2. Is that okay, all of you? Is that okay or not? See, this is basically the conductivity of element number 3. See, this is element number 3 whose conductivity is K2, and that is 30 watt per meter square degree Celsius, right? Then area we have taken as 1, and upon its thickness, that is length, it's 0.2. Okay, so just do this calculation and let me. Okay, so just let me know how much we're getting.
150.
Okay. So I'll put those values. 150 minus 150 minus 150 and plus 150. Right? Now, if you just see this element number 3, if you just see this element number 3, which is basically between node 3 and 4. This is basically between node 3 and 4. 3 and 4. Right? Now, let us go for element number 4. Now, let us go for element number 4. Okay. So stiffness matrix for element number 4 is given by conductivity of element number 4, which is basically K3, and K3 is 70, right? K3 is 70, into area is 1, upon its thickness is 0.15, into 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. Okay, so just do this calculation and let me know how much we're getting. Okay, 466.67 minus 466.67. Again, minus 466.67 and 466.67. Right, this is element stiffness matrix for element number 4. So element number 4 between 4, 5. So you write down 4, 5, and this is again 4, 5, 4, 5. Now what we have done, we have written individual element matrices for all the elements. Now we need to go for the calculation of global stiffness matrices, right? So now let's do that. Okay. So for that, we need to determine the size. Okay. So we need to determine the size of the global stiffness matrices. So size of the global stiffness matrix, size of the global stiffness matrix will be determined by number of nodes multiplied by degrees of freedom, okay, per node, right? So see, if you just see the problem, we have, okay, five nodes, and to each node we have only single degree of freedom, and that is nothing but a temperature. Okay, so I'll write on that as 1. Okay, so we'll get the size of the global stiffness matrix as 5 by 5, right? So let's do that. Okay, so now I will just determine that. Okay, so this is a global stiffness matrix. So P is given by, okay, I need to mark those many number of rows and then those many number of columns, right? Those many number of rows and many number of columns I should, right? So I'll just do that. So see, this is basically 1, okay? This is 2, 3, then we have 4 and 5. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I'll just extend it. Okay. So just do that. So I just mark the rows. I'll just mark the columns. Okay. So now what I'll do, I will just mark those rows and columns, right? So see, this is a very important step. Okay, you should clearly mark it in this manner only, then only the things become very easy. Okay, so try to understand this, right? So just now let's start speaking every element stiffness matrix and place it in a global stiffness matrix. So let's do that. So let's start with this one, element stiffness matrix for element number 1. Okay, so this is, you can see 1, 2, 1, 2. There will not be any problem. 1, 2, 1, 2. So starting point is 1, 1. So at 1, 1, I should put 30. So this is 1, I should put 30, right? The side of that, minus 30. Then here, minus 30. And here, plus 30, right? So this is what is done. Now go for this one, 2, 3, 2, 3. Okay, so just get the starting point, that is 2, 2. So this is 2 and this is 2, right? So at 2, 2, you put 83.33. The side of that, minus 83.33. Then here it is minus 83.33. Then here it is 83.33, right? Next, 3, 4, 3, 4. Here it is 150. So at 3, 3, you put 150. Okay, so I'll do that. See, at 3, 3, you put 150. So this is 3, this is 3, I will put 150. Here it is minus 150. Here it is minus 150. And here it is plus 150, right? Next, 4, 5, 4, 5. So at 4, 4, you put, okay, so this is 4, this is 4. You put 466.67. Here it is minus 466.67. Here it is minus 466.67. And here it is 466.67, right? So what we can do is for rest of the elements, okay, we can mark those with the zero value. So this is zero, this is zero, this is zero, 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 right? Again, zero, 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 here again, zero. Okay, then here again, zero, here again, zero, right? So this is what we are done. Now see how to check whether we are getting correct global stiffness matrix or not. See, at node number 2, I don't understand. At node number 2, 2 elements are connected. At node number 3, again 2 elements are connected. At node number 4, again 2 elements are connected. Okay, so see, at 2, 2, there are 2 terms. At 3, 3, there are 2 terms. Similarly, at 4, 4, there are 2 terms. Because see, this is node 2 where element number 1 and element number 2 are connected. This is node 3 where element number 2 and element number 3 are connected. This is node 4 where element number 4 and element number 5 are connected. Right? So this is how we'll understand. So this is, we have a global statement matrix. Now the next step is to go for or to solve is global matrix equation, that is basically known as GMD. Okay, so we will write down here now. So global matrix equation. Okay, global matrix equation, and that is basically known as GMD. is given by global matrix equation, that is GME is given by, see, this is our global stiffness matrix. When we multiply it by primary variable, that is temperature, is given by heat flow, that is given by Q, right? That is given by Q. Okay, so let's write that global matrix now. Okay, so we'll just write down those. This is 30, this is minus 30, 0, 0, 0, right? Then minus 30, then 30 plus 83.33. Just do the calculation. So that is 113.33. Then minus 83.33. And that is 0, 0, right? Then this is 0. Then minus 83.33. Then 83.33 plus 150. Okay, that is again 233.33. This is minus 150 and this is 0. Then 0, 0, minus 150. Then 150 plus 466.67. Just do this calculation.
616.67.
Okay. Then this is minus 466.67. Then this is 0. This value is 0. This value is 0. Minus 466.67 and 466.67. Okay. So this is a global stiffness matrix which we have got. Right. This is a global stiffness matrix. This has to be multiplied by temperatures. That is T1, T2, T3, T4, and T5. Okay. So these are the temperatures is given by heat flow. So heat flow, you know. Okay. That is Q1, Q2, Q3. Q4 and Q5. So these are the heat flows. These are the heat flows, right? Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and Q5. So these are the heat flows. Right? Now see, we need to solve this equation. Okay, we need to solve this equation. So as you know, see, for solving the equation, we need to impose certain boundary conditions. Certain boundary conditions we are supposed to impose. Right? Now let's come back to the diagram. Okay, now see, Here, the two temperatures which are given, we have yet not used. One is a temperature which is at the extreme right-hand side. That is basically the outer temperature, and that is 20. And one more temperature we have at the extreme left-hand side, and that is nothing but T infinity. Okay, and that is T infinity, it is given at 800 degrees Celsius, right? So see, T infinity, it is nothing but a T1, because it's the extreme left-hand side temperature. Okay. Because T infinity, it is the temperature of air. T infinity is the temperature of air. See here, you can. Convection heat transfer takes place on the inner surface of the wall with T infinity is equal to 800 degrees Celsius. So T infinity, that is 800 degrees Celsius, it is the temperature of the fluid which is flowing. Okay, so that is nothing but T1. And what is T2? What is T2? It is the temperature at the interface of the fluid and the inner surface. Okay, so this is line, it is nothing but this is a face, and this face, it is basically the connection between the flowing fluid and the material K1, okay, or the material with the conductivity K1, right? So what is T1? T1 is the temperature at the extreme left hand side, okay, and that is given as 800 degrees Celsius. Okay, so see here, this T1, it is 800 degrees Celsius. Try to understand this T1, it is 800 degrees Celsius. Similarly, temperature at the extreme right hand side, TO, is given, that is 20 degrees Celsius, and that is nothing but your T5. Okay, T5. So T5 is given, that is 20 degrees Celsius. This is 20, right? This is given as 20 degrees Celsius, right? This is given. Try to understand. This is very important. So you might feel that, sir, how you have taken T infinity as T1? See, T infinity is the temperature of the air. Okay. So that temperature of the air, it is nothing but T infinity. So obviously this is 800, and that air will transfer the heat to the inner face of the wall. Okay. To the inner face of the wall. Okay. And that temperature, it is T2. Right. Further, from this face of the wall to this face, the temperature is T3. From this face to this face, here the temperature is T4. Again, from this face to this face, the temperature is T5. That means at the extreme right hand side, the outer temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. Is that okay? Is that okay to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see, if you just solve this equation, what happens is, okay, when, yeah. What happens is when these terms, when any one of the T1 or T2 or T3, then T4 or T5, if any term, okay, out of T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, if it gets zero, then what we used to do, we used to delete that particular row and that particular column. But here you can see those terms are, no term is zero. Okay, no term is zero here. So what we need to do here, we need to just manually solve this equation. Okay, so now we will do that. We'll just manually solve that equation. Okay, so let's do that. First row and first column. Okay, first row and first column. Now see, before that, see T1, it is 800. T5, it's a 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, now see here, all of you, we are interested to calculate the value of T2, T3 and T4. We should know these values. Or we need to calculate what is the temperature here, T2. What is the temperature here, T3. What is the temperature here, T4. That we should know. So for getting the value of T2, T3 and T4, we should know the value of Q2, Q3 and Q4. Q2, Q3 and Q4. We should know these values. Then only we can calculate T2, T3 and T4. Now see, all of you, whatever amount of heat that is entering at node 1, whatever amount of heat that is entering at node 1, so same heat will go to node 2, same heat will go to node 3, same heat will go to node 4, same heat will go to node 5, and same heat will come out of node 5. Okay. So whatever amount of heat that is passing, it is constant, whether it is at node 1 or at node 2 or at node 3 or at node 4 or node 5. Now see, we are not supplying any additional heat at node 2, node 3 and node 4. Because whatever amount of heat that is entering through node 1, it is passing through all the nodes. We are not entering any external heat to node 2, node 3 or node 4. Okay. So these terms are zero. We are not entering any one of the heat, or we are not any adding any external heat to node 2, node 3 and node 4. Whatever the Q1 is entering, same heat it is flowing through Q2, Q3, Q4 and finally it is going out of Q5. Right? So that is the reason why I am taking this Q2, Q3, Q4 as zero. Right? See, for this particular numerical, you should have some knowledge of thermal engineering. Then only it will be okay. Okay, now see, now let's start doing that. First row by first column, it will give me the value of Q1. First row by column will give me the value of Q1. So let's do that. First row, that is 30 into 800, right? I will just write down directly. 30 into 800. See, this into this, this is 800. Minus 30 into T2. So I will write down plus minus 30 into T2. See, minus 30 into T2 plus 0 into T3 plus 0 into T4 plus 0 into T5 is equal to Q1. is equal to Q1, right? Equal to Q1. Okay. So from this equation, we'll be able to write down the value of Q1. Yes or no? Let me know. Are you able to understand this one or not? Let me know. See, first row, first column. Okay, first row multiplied by first column. So it will give you the value of?
Like matrix multiplication, na, sir?
Yes, nothing else more added. Right? Now let's do for second one. Let's do for second. Okay, this by this is equal to Q2, right? Second row by this column is equal to Q2. So second row, it is what? -30 into 800. So I'll write on that. -30 into 800. -30 into 800 plus 113.33 into T2 plus -83.33 into T3 plus 0 into T4 plus 0 into T5 is equal to Q2. Okay, and that is equal to 0. And that is equal to 0. Right? Yes or no? Okay. So just let me know how much it is getting. So I will just write down that. So 113.33 into T2, then -83.33 into. See, this second row by this column, this is the basic mathematics. You should know how to do the multiplication of the matrices. See, second row by this column. So -30 into this plus 113.33 into T2 plus -83.33 into T3 plus 0 into T4 plus 0 into T5 is equal to Q2, and that is equal to 0. Right? See, if you need to calculate the value of Q2, just have a second row by this column. That is the only thing which I done. Okay. Now see, if this it is written. So when you bring this term on this hand side, it becomes plus, okay? And that is basically 24,000. Okay, 24,000. So let me just, okay, this is 24,000, right? Now let's do for Q3. So third row by this column. Okay, so 0 into 800, that is 0, right? Then -83.33 into T2, that I will write down. -83.33 into T2 plus 233.33 into T3 plus -150 into T4 plus -150 into T4 plus 0 into T5, that is 0, is equal to Q3, and that is equal to 0. Right? Third row by this column is equal to Q3 and is equal to 0. Right? Okay. So let's do the calculation. Okay. So let's see how much we are getting. Okay. So this is T2. Okay, this is in the form of T2. So I'll just write down that equation as it is. Right. So let's keep that as it is. There is no scope for the calculation here. So let's keep this equation as it is. Right. Okay. Now go for next calculation. Fourth row by this column is equal to Q4 and that is equal to 0. Fourth row, this column is equal to Q4 and that is equal to 0. So 0 into 800 is 0. 0 into T2 is 0, -150 into T3, that I will write down, -150 into T3, plus 616.67 into T4, plus 616.67 into T4, plus this value, plus 4 plus minus 4 66.67 into T5. Into T5 is 20. Into T5 is 20. See this into this. Is equal to Q4. Is equal to Q4 and is equal to 0. Okay. Is equal to 0. Right. Is that okay? Okay. Just check it all of you. Okay. So what I will do is, okay, so this is minus 150. Okay, this is minus 150. Okay. Into T3. Okay, so that I will write down into T3 plus 616.67 into T4. Okay. Now just multiply this 20 into this term. Okay, just multiply this and let me know how much we are getting. Minus 466.67 into 20. So just let me know that.
Minus 933.4.
Okay, so when I bring that on the right hand side, it becomes plus, right? 933.4. Is that okay? Is that okay or not? Let me know. Is that okay or not? Okay. So see, all of you just see now this is very important. So just see this equation. All of you just see this equation, which is in the form of T2 and T3. Okay. I will call this as equation number one. Okay. Now let me see this equation. This is in the form of T2, T3 and T4. See, this is in the form of T2, T3 and T4. Okay. So let you call this as one more equation. See, this is very important equation. Okay. So this you called is as equation number two. This you call it as equation number two, right? This is in the form of T2 and T3. This is in the form of T2, T3 and T4, right? Now you have one more equation. Let me call this as equation number three. Okay. And this equation, it is in the form of T3 and T4. Yes or not? This is in the form of T3 and T4. See, if you see, you have T2 and T3. You don't have T4. So its coefficient is zero. Here you have all T2, T3 and T4. Here you have T3 and T4. You don't have T2. So its coefficient is zero. Right. Now these three equations we need to solve in calculator. Right. This is very important. So I'll write down solving equation one, two and three. One, two, three. So from that, we will get the value of T2, we'll get the value of T3, and we will get the value of T4. Okay. So just solve this in a calculator. Okay. So how to do that? Okay. How you do those? Okay. Just start putting the value. Okay. First. Okay. So just start putting those values. I will let you know how to do that. Okay. Basically, we are supposed to open. Right, we are supposed to open that calculator. Okay, go to mode. Okay, then go to solve the system equations with three unknowns. Okay, then start putting the value. Coefficient of T2, it's 113. It is. Okay, 113.33. Then coefficient of T3 is minus 83.33. Then here you don't have the coefficient of T4, that is zero. And right hand side is 24,000. Right. Now come back to down. Coefficient of T2, it's minus 83.33. Then here coefficient is 233.33. Then here coefficient is minus 150 and right hand side is zero. Then here there is no coefficient of T2, so it is zero. For T3 it is minus 150 and for T4 it is 616.67 and right hand side is 933.4. So when I put this, okay, I will get the value. Okay, so this is the value of T2, that is 319.79. Okay, and then T3, 146.91, and T4, 50.87. Okay, 50.87. You can see these values, right? Okay, so these values which we have calculated by using calculator, and they are in degree Celsius, right? Now, how to check whether our answers are correct or not, right? So for that, okay, we used to check the condition of equilibrium. Okay, so let's start calculating the value of Q1. So equation for the Q1 I already written. So let me write down that equation again. Okay, so first row by this column is Q1. Okay, so 30 into 800, that is what is it? You can see 30 into 800, try to understand. 30 into 800, I am repeating this same line again. 30 into 800 plus minus 30 into T2. Okay, so plus minus 30 into T2. Okay, into T2, then 0 into T3, 0 into T4, 0 into T5 is equal to Q1. Okay, so when you put these values in the equation, just put these values in the equation. Okay, so just put this 30 into 800 plus minus 30 into T2. T2 we got 319.79. is equal to Q1, is equal to Q1. Okay, so just get the value of Q1. Okay, calculate the value of Q1. Just let me the value of Q1. Because same sort of exercise we need to repeat for Q5. So fifth row by this column is equal to Q5. So let's do that. 0 into 800 is 0. 0 into T2 is 0. 0 into T3 is 0. Then minus 466.67 into T4. So minus 466.67 into T4. Into T4 plus 466.67 into T5 plus 466.67 into T5, and T5 is given as 20, is equal to Q5, is equal to Q5, right? So let me know the value of Q1. So I will write out here. So minus 466.67 into T4, we have calculated 50.87 plus 466.67 into 20 is equal to Q5. So from this you can get the value of Q5. So let me know the value of Q1 and Q5. Let us know the value of Q1 and Q5. Okay. So once we have those values, we can take the summation of Q. Okay. So that is basically addition of Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 plus Q5. Okay. So for that, I should know these values. What value of Q1 you're getting? Let me know. What value of Q1 you're getting? Let me know the value of Q1, all of you. What value of Q1 you are getting? It will be better if you speak, not to put the in the chat box. Much
14406.3
14406 na 14406
point 3 point 3
four four 0.06.3.
Yeah, this are.
Okay. This is in watt per meter square. This is very important. Unit is very important because we have taken the area as one. So this you will get it in watt per meter square. Similarly, what is the value of Q5? What is the value of Q5? What is the value of Q5?
Sir, same answer आ रहा है but minus में है.
Yes, yes, and that should you get right minus 14406.3 watt per meter square. Okay, you should get the same answer because ultimately your summation should tends to zero. Okay, so when I put these values Q1, I got this 14406.3 plus Q2 is zero, Q3 is zero, Q4 is zero, plus this value is minus 14406.3, right? So when you calculate the summation of forces, heat summation of heat, it will come as zero. Summation of heat will come as zero, right? So that means whatever the temperature distribution you got or the temperature values you got, they are correct values. Is that okay? Similarly, see what is Q1? It is the amount of heat entering. So how much heat it is entering? 14406.3. So obviously, how much it will leave? Same, na? 14406.3. See, same means we are getting the same value, right? When amount of heat entering, we are getting same as amount of heat leaving. Then only we can claim that the values of temperature that we have got are correct, right? See, one is plus, it means entering. One is minus, it means it is leaving. Both are having same magnitude and having different direction because this is with the plus sign, this is with the negative sign. And when you add all those heats, we are getting this value as zero, right? Is that okay, all of you?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Is that okay, all of you? Or is there any doubt? Okay.
No,
so, okay. So what we'll do, today we're going to stop here. And in the next lecture, we will take one problem on a fluid analysis. And once we have done with the fluid analysis, so after that, we can start with the numerical methods, that is solution of differential equation, weak methods, like, you know, weak methods, non-weak methods like those. Okay. So today we are going to stop. And in the next lecture, we will take the problem on thermal fluid analysis, followed by the solution of the differential equation by using exactly.